So what, as I'm pulling this up, what I'm going to walk you all through is an experience that we put together inside of Teams, of course, that's honestly made my life a lot easier, as well as a lot of our customer success managers around the globe. Now, for some quick background here before I actually go into the team and show you what we're doing, we are running these customer workshops around the globe where we'll talk about what is the focus of my role, which is Teams platform. And really what that means is, how do customers leverage these investments they've made, whether or not Microsoft built them, mm-hmm. and bring them into the Teams experience so they have more value? So it's really fun because we show examples and use cases of organizations and what they're doing all over the globe. Now, planning these takes a little bit of time and effort, as you can imagine, because a lot of people are coming, big customers and organizations that we work with, and there's a lot of skin in the game, if you will. And we wanted to make this process easier, not only for myself, so every time we set up a meeting, we don't have to necessarily have a call just to tell people what we can do, but at the same time, make it easy for the customer success manager to plan these quickly and go ahead and invite their customers and their peers so we can make an impact, frankly. Mm-hmm. So, first thing we do, I normally will get a message from a customer success manager that says, I want to set up, we call these platform roadshows. I want to set up a platform roadshow. And I go, cool. So I invite them into the team. And here's where you see one of the first goodies, if you will, of this team here, mm-hmm. is we have this automated message set up right here that welcomes every new person into the team.
Nice.
Now, if you're not familiar with Power Automate or Flow at Microsoft, one of our products in Power Platform, all it is a set of triggers and actions. That's really what it is at its core. Mm-hmm. And so the trigger here is it recognizes somebody new has been added to the team. The action is that it posts this message right here in the channel to let the person know, not only welcoming them to the team, but what's going to happen next.
And this is so important too, Jace, because I know that a lot of my customers that plan events, it's a lot of manual processes. There's a lot of emails going out. And I think this not only helps with that, but what's cool is it captures that sentiment. Like, you can see there's a heart there. People can reply to that, make them really feel welcome.
Sure. And just a real quick view and a little sneak peek of something that's coming. So I'm on our early engineering build, so I've got access to some of these features that we just announced at our Ignite conference, which is our major customer conference, if anybody's not familiar. And just by clicking what we call a message extension right here, and if I go down to more actions, there's a flow that I've got embedded into this Teams experience. And so I'll show you this real quick, because it's incredibly easy to set up that welcome message that I just created. Now, again, this is coming soon. You're getting a little sneak peek of this. And in the meantime, while this is loading, just so you know, this template is available already, publicly available on flow.microsoft.com. And it's welcome. It's a welcome message for new users when they join a team. Mm-hmm. But inside of Teams, what's coming here is I can click on this. And once it authenticates me, it's going to give me the option for what do I want to put in my welcome message after I hit continue right here. And that's mm-hmm. all I did to set up this welcome message right here. As I set this up, I let it know which channel I'm putting this in, and boom, we're good to go.
Fantastic.
So you can imagine that saves me a ton of time having to explain this over and over again, how the process works with our customer success managers. Now they pop in, they know what to do, they know I'm setting up a channel, and that's all sorted.
So now that you showed that, so let's say me, and actually this is a real life example because I'm about to run a few events. I'm going to start one in October. So walk me through that user, right? Millen wants to create an event in October. You welcome Millen to the team. What's next?
Sure. So you get this message because I've embedded an at mention in here, so it tags you, you'll get a notification in your activity feed as well. Mm-hmm. So it'll say you've been added to a new team, you've also been tagged in this post. Yep. Now, this post, when you walk through it, the long story short of it is I make you an owner of the team because I want you as the lead to be able to invite your peers into the team and not have to wait. You know, you don't want you to have to wait on me, so I'm a bottleneck. I will also create a team that has some kind of label that's relevant to either your region you work in, the type of customers you're working with, et cetera. So you can see I've got a bunch on here. We're doing one for Heineken. We've got some for Sweden, et cetera.
Yeah.
So get that set up. And then finally, I create a tag. If anybody's not familiar, I won't go through the whole process of creating these, but if you click on the ellipses in a channel, you can create a tag. Mm-hmm. And the reason a tag is a beautiful thing is because we can create a tag for just our planning team that we're working on for this roadshow. So instead of at mentioning a whole team where everybody else in this team gets a notification, we can just at mention the group that we have set up on the tag. And just to give you a visual of this so everyone can see, these are incredibly valuable if you want to reduce the noise, if you will, of notifications inside of the Teams experience. We've created a bunch of tags for one of these events. And you can see, I usually name it team and then where they're from or what industry they're looking at or the region they're covering, et cetera. And again, all you need to do is at mention, just like you do users inside of teams or channels, and all those people who are part of the tag get the notification.
Very cool.
Now, I posted this here. We're going to automate this here soon, but I've got a bunch of tabs up here in the general channel that we use on a regular basis. And the first one is this welcome message. Mm-hmm. And so this is just a wiki tab. But what I do is I control A to copy everything, and I copy that. And then I go into the channel of choice. And let me find one that we're doing recently. I think Netherlands is a good one. So we just set up a channel for Netherlands not too long ago. We're going to do this for the team in Amsterdam. And I paste the welcome message and tag the team.
Gotcha.
So you can see team NLS, that's a tag that I created right there. Mm-hmm. And it gives them all the information they need. So what are the next steps? What information do they have in the general channel? And so these are the tabs that I've set up. And just to walk you through them, so we don't need to go through each one of them,
right,
is I've got a OneNote that walks you through the event. We've got the deck saved there that we use to get started with our presentation. And then there's videos of us previously doing this. The last thing we do that is really cool here is if you need a registration page set up, so an external registration website, here's the process. And if you click on that link, what it does is it takes you straight to this tab that we have in the general channel. Now, Milan, I know you're familiar with these, but these are forms. And so if you want to set one of these up, really simple and easy to do, if you go to forms.microsoft.com, or excuse me, right there, and yeah, you can set these up. So what we're doing is we're asking the customer success managers to give us the information that we need in order to get a registration page properly set up so they can go share this with their customers and we start getting folks ready for the event.
Right.
Now, the beauty of this is, last thing I'll show you on Flow here, is we also have a flow that notifies us when someone submitted a new registration page. So this just happened today. And we can see the submission details and go ahead and set that page up. And then what we do to make it easy for folks to find this page is we go back into that channel for that event. And we add a tab, and if anybody's never done this before, really simple and easy to do this, just hit the plus sign, mm-hmm, and we add a website tab. And so long story short, once this pulls up, I would hit website. I would actually paste the URL of that registration page. I'm getting the spiral wheel of death right now. but you can log the registration page. That's right there, the website tab. And you can save the registration page as a tab. That way, everyone always knows that they've got it sitting right in the channel where we're planning together.
Wow. That's fantastic. So you've created a one-stop shop from beginning to end on basically event management all within Microsoft Teams.
Sure, man. Trying to make lives easier. Yeah. And then we just collaborate on there as we get closer to the event, work on, you know, who's going to take care of what part, who's going to moderate, et cetera. But it's made the process a lot smoother, in all honesty. And I hate admitting this, but selfishly, that was a lot of my goal, is how do I make life easier, not only for myself, but for us, so we can ultimately do the things we love, which are talking to our customers and running these events.
I love it. And I even see too, you put like a pitch video there. I'm assuming that yeah, just helps you land these with your customer if you want to pitch the event itself.
Yeah, because we've got a lot of customer success managers who want to do these on their own as well. Some ask for some support, some want to do it on their own. And so for those who are doing this on their own, they said, look, we've actually recorded quite a few of these, not only in bite-sized chunks, so to speak. And what we've done here is we've just embedded a stream channel as a tab. And so you can see these previously loaded videos that were live events or the way that we share some of this content and information. So you can go and learn it yourself.
I love it. I can see so many use cases with this, not only for events, but even just learning and development. If you're training your organization, you have a series of trainings that you want to manage. This is great stuff. Is there anything else you'd want to leave us with?
Start with the easy stuff. I think it's really easy to get so excited and overwhelmed when it comes to Microsoft Teams because there's so much you can do. But everything I did here, I've got no technology backgrounds, require no coding. You could do this really simply and easily. It's just organizing and centralizing people and the tools that you need. So yeah, start simple and then the doors will open from there.